Good afternoon, Stock Stout. Back, gonna try out some Rogue Legacy. I've been playing this game for about an hour. Looking forward to trying it. I'm not using my normal intro because you can hear the rockin' tunes of this game by Cellar Door in the background. Let's get in game and see what's going on. So, in Rogue Legacy, you've got a family tree. Every time one of your people dies, you have to play one of the heirs. I've died quite a bit. It's the Fallen Heroes. So we have a choice between Lady Jenny, the barbarian queen with gigantism and baldness, Lady Shanoa, the knave, who has no traits, or Lady Faye, the knave, who has gigantism and embellus. She can't cast spells. I actually want to try out a knave. So we're going to try an adventure with the traitless hero, which gets a little achievement. Fair warning, I've been having some overheating problems, so if the stream suddenly drops while I'm doing this, it's because my computer's overheated and crashed. Here you've got the keep that you rebuild with the gold you've got. I didn't actually get very much gold in my last run. You have the blacksmith, where you can buy the weapons that you've gotten blacksmith patterns for. The enchantress has runes that you can attach to your gear to give you abilities like the double jump I've got here. And this guy's the architect. You can lock the castle in its previous configuration and only get a percentage of your gold. As you go in, any money not spent is lost. Otherwise, the castle is built randomly every time, aside from this opening room. Try to get through and smash a little bit and go into the castle. You immediately have monsters all over the place. This is a platformer meets roguelike. And our, looks like our volume on the music's just a little loud, so I'm going to turn that down a little bit. Alright. That should be better. I don't have to fight over the game sound quite as much. You know, let's go just a little more. And turn the sound effects down a little bit. There we go. Okay, in order to get the fairy chest here, we have to navigate these spikes without taking any damage. Ah, we failed. No point in going up there. Alright. Hit points are up in the upper left-hand corner. Oh boy. The knave's special ability is the critical hit. Oh, tried to get that treasure chest. Lady Shanoa has been slain by a skeleton. Her last words are vampirism, and siphon runes are very powerful when stacked. That's useful last words. The next generation, Sir Skunky the Mage, Lady Jenny the Mage. He's got colorblind and dextrocardia. Or Lady Chun-Li the Paladin. I want to play Sir Skunky. We have hardly any gold, so we're colorblind, so it's all black and white. We will pay all of our money and go back in. One of our downsides swapped our hit points and magic pool, so I can cast all sorts of spells with this guy, but I can't take very many hits. Ooh. Mage's special abilities is whenever they do a kill, they can refill some of their magic points. I don't know what the cooldown on the stopwatch is, though. Oh, interesting. I take damage off of my magic points, and I cast with my hit points. That's goofy. That looked like it would be good for a mage, but I don't know that it was. Looks like I'm more of a fighter mage. Defeat all enemies. fairy chest. Oh, that's... Wow, okay. It's a level 13 Glacian. Wow, okay. Brutal. Sir Skunky. Didn't make it out of that. One more time. Lady Winry, who has coprolalia and ADHD. I think I'm going to want to play the Paladin with ADHD. Even less gold than last time to spend on upgrades. Oh, because I've got ADHD, I move real fast. And the castle randomly rebuilds itself again. Smash that chair. Paladin's special ability is the shield. Oh! I move so fast I'm throwing myself off. Pretty sweet. I'm gonna miss this character when I inevitably die. This castle configuration's not too bad either. Oh, jeez. Holy crap, these things are dangerous. We swear every time we get hit. Wow. Slain by Amon. Her last words are swearing. And one more time. Sir Lancelot the Paladin, who's got eidetic memory. Lady Lisa the Third, who has hypergonadism. She's a knave. Sir Hershey the Mage. Let's go Sir Lancelot. I do have 200 gold this time. Let's see. Can I buy any upgrades? Costs 230. Let's see if we've got any upgrades available here. Got the Vampiric Sword equipped. Man, these are all expensive. What about this cape? Cape's 500 gold. We gotta actually be successful to get any upgrades at this point. That's even 350. Alright. See if eidetic memory helps us at all. Oops. Looks like we're paused here for a second. Alright. Now we're back. Ooh. This reminds me a lot of, like, Ghosts and Goblins meets Castlevania. Ooh, boy. That's not good. I haven't really done anything, and I've already taken a ton of damage. Looks like... My eidetic memory showing monsters wherever they are on the map. No, we're not gonna go there. That looks dangerous. Oh, looks like it's showing a chest. Some sort on that. There's a chest in this room, too. I'm gonna have to survive to get all this gold. It's only 320 and I'm almost dead. Determine we need, like, minimum 350 to make a trip worth it. Get a few more hit points. Ugh! I panicked. Ugh, my spell did me no good. Slain by a Charite. And these tips on how to let their sons and daughters survive. OCD Barbarian Queen. And we'll play Lady Fae. 340 gold, just shy of being able to do anything interesting. I can get more hit points for 310. That's useful. And as we purchase upgrades, our level in the upper left-hand corner increases. It's pretty sweet. I guess there are bosses, too. I played the demo and got a boss, but didn't get a whole lot of look, a very long look at it. I just kind of died shortly after encountering the boss. I just gotta be a little bit more careful. Because every time I take a swing, I do recover a little bit of hit points. That's pretty sweet. Already at 200 gold and haven't really done anything. Barbarian Queen ability is the Dragon Shout. I haven't needed to use it yet, though. Farodus. Alright, that painting's not gonna come to life. Just keep smashing stuff for more gold. Sweet. Fairy chest objective, take no damage. I do not have the appropriate rune to do that one. You need to be able to dash, I think. Do those shoot through walls? No, they do not. Do all the smashing I can. We're at 330. I think get something cool at like 500 gold. Oof. Sweet. 500 gold it is. Do just a little better each time. Oh yeah, you're not standing in a very smart place, are you? Yeah! Now what do we have here? Sort of holy jukebox. Does it actually cost me to... Oh no. So we could just change the music in there. Ah. Doesn't look like the jukebox tunes switch. Oof! That was dumb. And my spell doesn't seem all that useful though. Oh, okay. I'll take that back. That was pretty cool. Obama was dead. Sweet. Oh boy. I can kill these guys and make use of my vampire sword a little bit. Double jump up here and try and get the chest. 870 gold. Yep, that was an animated painting. Trying to heal our way back up. My killing guys got a long way to go. 37 out of 195 hit points. Oh, jeez. Whew. Sweet. 1,000. I don't think I've ever had this.